guys. I just had a few questions about working with tea bags. When I put this up on the internet, this junk journal that I'm still working in, a lot of questions came in about working with tea bags. What, how, and why? Well, I'll share with you what I've been up to and see if I can answer just a few questions. Can you decoupage onto tea bags? Yes, you can. So here is a large napkin here that has been glued onto these tea bags, and these have had a hit with acrylic wax. Do have a tutorial on acrylic wax. It basically makes it waterproof and more durable. So can you use a napkin? Can you glue it on? Yes is the answer. Does it have to be this big? No. If you just want to use a small section, please do. This was just me playing around. Next, fabric. Can you put fabric and back your tea bags? Yet again, yes you can. Here we have just some plain 100% cotton, which has been coffee stained up, and I've used ThermoWeb. I've just ironed it on to the back of these tea bags. And you'll see that there is just a little bit of sheen there. There's some of the heat and bond, which I just haven't put a tea bag onto around here. But yep, you can iron fabric onto the back, probably glue it. Stamping, more stamping, but this time just using coloured pencils, just good old-fashioned colouring pencils to do some colouring. Absolutely no reason why you can't do that. Playing around with colours and sewing. Okay, if you use fruity teas, you can obviously express yourself in a different way. I've been using some strawberry and raspberry tea bags, and I've been doing some patchwork. So I've been out on the sewing machine. It's been a wee while, I won't say, since I've been doing my patchwork. But I have just been toying and playing with different ways that you can put things together. And if I turn around and said that this tea bag here was also stained using the strawberry and raspberry tea, I'll explain in a few seconds the reasons why we got to a much darker black-purple variety of tea bag. But as you can see, these are two round tea bags here and an oblong, and I've just been trying to play on the sewing machine, folding it in different directions and then cutting into it and then gluing it down. I'm not much into origami, but like everything, I do like to play around. So once that sewing machine was out, I was just toying with what I could do to the best of my ability, making little pockets, just sort of like, so this could be opened up. It's not going to be able to open it up, not that I'm doing it on camera because I can't see for the life of me, but there we go. I suppose once you start, you've just got to achieve. But I'll be putting tags in there, put tags down there, just playing around, sewing them together. They're, rather than paper, you can literally sew and turn the paper the opposite way around, and you can see that all my seams are inside here, so I've made like a roll. Not too sure where I was going with it, but there you go. More patchwork, just in a slightly different way. Now, colours. So I had a strawberry and raspberry set of tea bags. I put 10 into a teapot and poured the tea into an aluminium pan and immersed some paper, some lace, and a bit of wool into the diluted tea bags. Soaked them overnight, then took some of my dried tea bags here, just the black, this would have had black tea in it, and then put these into the dye bath. And I didn't expect them to turn purpley stroke black, but that is how they came out. So they virtually started to stain up immediately. So a variety of colours to work with. People have been using turmeric, any of your spices from your spice rack that could turn, you know, certain berries are going to turn things different ways, turmeric's going to turn things yellow. It's really experimentation. You play, you enjoy, you see where you're going with this. Decorations that I've done in the past, I just want to share with you a couple more things. You can patchwork. So this has got wadding, placed into the tea bag, blanket stitch around the outside and just running stitch in the centre. So that's my blueberry pie. So I made an embellishment, I just put a little paper clip behind that one. Tea bags again, but paper piecing, and you could probably have some scrapbook paper to make it a little bit more exciting, and you could wrap more and more around, and then you've got a fixed piece, a little shape going on there. And packaging. Here is my Yorkshire tea, and I have just decided to finish off this stone wall. A little 5-minute sketch here, and I know it's probably not as clear and I don't have a zoom on this iPad, but you can sketch away on your tea bags to your heart's content. And this wasn't the pen that I used, but this one I would recommend is a Micron. It's an archival pen. I used a 0.2, this happens to be a 0.4 that has been shown to you. So, just some suggestions on what you can do with your teabag art. I'll catch up with you later, guys. Bye-bye.